This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about analyzing graphs of polynomial functions. So here's the first graph. I've got a very rough graph here. I've got an x and y axis, but there are no numbers on the graph. Now, even without numbers, I can still state quite a few things about the original function. I can do that by looking at the end behavior of the graph and also at the number of turning points. So let's start with the end behavior. You notice that both ends of the graph go down. If both ends of the graph go in the same direction, either both down or both up, that means that the function had to be an even degree. Now, if they both go down, that means the lead coefficient was a negative number. And in this case, they both go down. So the lead coefficient is negative. I can also look at the number of turning points and find something out about what the degree might have been. I've got three turning points here, and we've got a general rule that says that the degree had to be at least one more than the number of turning points. So we'll take that three turning points and add one, and that means that this was at least degree four. If it wasn't degree four, since I said at least, then the next possible degree would be degree six, because it's got to stay even. That's what my end behavior told me. So this is at least degree four, but it could be degree six or eight or 10. Or any other even number. Okay, here's another one. Once again, there's no numbers, but I can look at the turning points and the end behavior and draw some conclusions. In this case, the end behavior has one end going down and one end going up. When the ends go in opposite directions, that means that you've got a polynomial with an odd degree. When it's odd and the left end is down and the right end is up, that means that the lead coefficient was positive. And now we can count the turning points and see what that tells me about the degree. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six turning points. I'll add one, and that means that this was at least degree 7. And again, if it's not degree 7, then the next possible degree would be 9, because I can only have odd degrees. So it'd be 7 or 9 or 11 and so on. Here's another one. I want to make a comment about turning points. So this is a fairly simple graph. It's just kind of an S-curve. We can start out by looking at the end behavior. That's one end going up and one end going down. So when they go in opposite directions, that's going to be an odd degree. If it's an odd degree and it starts out up on the left end and goes down on the right end, that means the lead coefficient is negative. And now let's look at turning points. So you might be used to thinking of a turning point as just a minimum or a maximum, like the bottom of a hill or the top of a hill. But this graph has two turning points. Think of yourself as driving in a car along this curve. First, you would turn your steering wheel in one direction over here, then you would turn it in another direction over here. So there are actually two turning points. We're going to add one more to that. That'll give us three. That means that this is at least degree three. Okay, and it's time for one more. So let's do this one. I'll start out with the end behavior. Both ends of the graph go up. So since they both go in the same direction, it's an even degree. And since that direction they go in is up, that means the lead coefficient is positive. And now I'll count the turning points. I've got this S curve over here, so that's one turning point and then two. Here's another one down at the bottom of the graph, that's three. I'll add one more to that. So that means that the graph is at least, at least degree four. Okay, so the basic idea is look at your end behavior, decide whether it's an even degree or an odd degree polynomial. Also decide whether the leading coefficient is positive or negative. You get all of that from the end behavior. Then count the number of turning points that you have, add one to it, and that will tell you what the smallest possible degree would be for your polynomial. Okay? That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.